Today we're going to look at the evolution of the animals. Continuing our survey on the diversity of life, we're going to use the diversification of the animals and revisit some old concepts of convergence and homology. Remember that there are two principal ways to earn a living out there. One is as an autotroph, whereby you produce your own organic nutrients through photosynthesis. That makes you a plant or an algae. Otherwise, you're a heterotroph. You have to obtain your nutrients from other organisms. You have to eat, like animals and fungus. Now, in looking at animal evolution, we want to be paying particular attention to their lifestyle. Being heterotrophic, animals need a digestive system, they need sense organs, and mobile animals need a circulatory system, a musculoskeletal system. And as we think about this and the evolution of the animals, we're going to pay attention to what sort of traits might have been retained from the ancestor. So these are homologies, or what we get with parallel evolution. These are analogies. So remember, homology is if you had a common ancestor with a particular bone structure in its forearm, we often see in structures like that, that basic overall pattern is retained, whether it's in a whale that no longer has fingers but instead has flippers, or with bats who have those very flimsy wings, or even a horse that only has one toe. So the main structures have been retained, and we can tell the evolutionary history because of those similarities through homology. On the other hand, certain traits get evolved over and over again because there's one best way to travel quickly through the water, and that's to be streamlined. And so the shape of a shark is superficially rather similar to that of a penguin and a dolphin. But this is a fish, a bird, and a mammal, and these similarities have evolved repeatedly at different times.